Assalamualaikum and welcome to our daily news with me, Nur Atiraholik. Malaysia is a developing country and has gone through a lot of development phases, especially in the urban area. After a new century began, green technology is one of the technologies that has been introduced for urban area development. To transform the building market and transfiguring the common way of thinking about design, inhabit and operate buildings, the idea of green building has been introduced under this technology. Green technology is focusing in enhancing the efficiency of resources used such as energy, water and materials while reducing the building impact on human health and the environment during the building life cycle. Concerning the idea of green building, an organization known as Green Buildings Index Organization under the subsidiary of Pertubuhan Arkitek Malaysia and the Association of Consulting Engineers Malaysia has introduced Green Building Index as the local green building rating system to the public. The Green Building Index, Malaysia's industry recognized green rating tool for building to promote sustainability in the built environment and raise awareness among developers, architects, engineers and the public about environmental issues and our responsibility to the future generations. In order for a building to be classified as green, it needs to fulfill certain requirements that can give more understanding on how the Green Building Index rating tool helps reduce its carbon footprint. Now I turn to Ilya Najia Azhar, live from GBL Building.
Hi, Assalamualaikum. My name is Ilya Najia. So we are at Kuantan. So today I would like to explain about the requirement of green buildings. So before that, I'm sure that you guys already know that green building should be designed and operate to reduce the overall impact of the building environment on its surrounding. So the first requirement is energy efficiency. This covers how the building design deals with the distributor of energy and its consumption. It states that in order for a building to be considered green, but it must optimize building orientations, harvesting as much as natural light as possible, minimize solar heat gain, use renewable energy in building and services, and ensure a proper testing and commissioning and regular maintenance of energy use. So the second requirement for the green building is indoor environment quality. The outside environment is not the only things that influence our health, but the quality of our indoor environment also play a role major. This involves the use of quality air filtration method as well as a proper ventilation. By creating a better indoor environment, we can reduce energy expenditure.
So we continue the third requirement for green building. A green building is only truly green if it was environmentally friendly and suitable material and resource when being built, and afterward to maintenance and running of the facilities. Builder must also practice proper waste management system with the storage collection.
The last requirement of green building that I will share is water efficiency. These include using method through which is the building may recycle water and use water saving fitting in their pipe to prevent unnecessary wastage of water. It also include methods such as rainwater harvesting and filtrations of used water.
Green building rating systems are used as environmental assessment method applied for building that emerge as a widely adopted way to evaluate the performance of a building across a broad range of environmental considerations. Points are given for performance above benchmarks and current industry practice. To find out more about the Green Building Index rating system, we will connect with our reporter Muhammad Faiz Muhammad Hakimi, also live from GBI.
Assalamualaikum, I am Muhammad Faiz. Today, I will share with you guys about the building included with their rating in Green Building Index. In general, rating in GBI divided into 4 stages, which is certified, silver, gold and platinum. We are going to see the example of each rating. Let's start with the certified level first. We are now in front of the Leisure Farm Resort Central Spin at Iskandar, Malaysia, Johor. This is an example of the certified building in GBI. The point required to get the certified level is between 50 to 65 points. Let's go into Silver Rating building. Generally, Silver Rating is a little advanced compared to the certified level, which is required 66 to 75 points. We are now at one of the example of Silver Rating, which is Bandar Kemudian Gardens in Selangor. Look at this place. There are many plants in here. It is to make this building more eco-friendly. Now, let's see the example of the next rating, which is Gold Rating. The building behind me is Kemuda Core Business District at Dengkil, Selangor. The point is that in this rating, it's a little bit higher with the Silver Rating, which is required 76 to 85 points. This district is Business District, and the reason why it's Gold Rating because it's applied 3R, which is Reduce, Reuse and Recycle, and even use low energy consumption. Let's look the last example of building in top tier rating in Green Building Index, which is Platinum level. The building behind me is one of the new phase in Kuala Lumpur City Skyline, which is Tun Razak Exchange. Tun Razak Exchange has invested heavily in order to achieve sustainability, eco-friendly initiative site-wide, such as proper waste water management, pedestrian-friendly infrastructure, energy and cooling utilization. Platinum level require 86 to 100 points. And why this Tun Razak Exchange get the platinum level? Because it also include one open green space, sports and play facilities, as well as venue space in the building. So no wonder why this building gets the platinum rating. These are only a few examples of Green Building Index. There are more in the outside. If you guys want to see and explore with your own eyes, you can go if this pandemic is reduced. But remember to follow the safety protocols when you go explore with yourself. And I am Muhammad Faiz. That's all for me.
Across the nation, the building companies now have target to achieve a building that values sustainability and awarded with GBI certification. For a building to be awarded with four types of rate, the applicants first need to go through a few stages before the GBI certificate is issued. To get the clear flow and information on how to apply the Green Building Index, we are now with one of the officer of GBI, Mr. Amir Iman Azami, to get his clarification on the process of application.
Assalamualaikum. Here we have Mr. Amir from Green Building Index Organization. So Mr. Amir, can you explain a little bit to us how the process of Green Building application?
Okay, so I'm Mr. Amir from Green Building Organization. Okay, so for the building application process of this building event, we have three stages, which is application, design and verification stage. Okay, the first stage is application and registration. So you can submit all the form application, including the contact details, project information, and the supporting document to Green Building Index Sdn Bhd. Okay, for your information, the registration fee will be set up depending on the project size. And after that, you will sign the application registration between the applicant and GSP. Then the GBI certifier will be appointed to the project. Okay, for the second stage is design assessment. So first, after the applicant is ready, you can submit the project application to the design assessment team. So for this design assessment, the applicant should follow all the criteria put by the GBI team. And then the GBI certifier will undertake the design assessment, which involves the presentation of the project team of the applicant. The assessment report will be produced to register and award the certification. Then it will be issued with the accompanying GBI scores to show the scores achieved. For the last one is stage 3, which is the completion and verification assessment. So after the whole project complete, the applicant should submit the completion and verification assessment within 12 months or after the building 50% occupied. Then the final GBI award will be issued to the building, which the building will be awarded platinum, gold, silver or certificate rating based on the scores achieved. The last one is, the building must be reassessed
after 3 years in order to maintain the GBI rating to ensure the building well maintained and in good condition.
We've reached the end of the interview, so Mr. Amin, do you have any final words?
Okay, if you have any question, you can visit our website at Green Building Index. Okay, that's all. Thank you.
Back to the station.
Since the launch of Green Building Index, over 389 registered GBI project in Malaysia in 2013, which shows that Green Building Index has given many benefits since it offers a chance for developers and structure owners to plan and build green. I turn now to Nur Hiswani Ismail to give clear understanding on the importance of green building.
Assalamualaikum, you are here with me, Nur Hiswani Ismail. So what is the importance of GBI?
There are 6 importance of GBI. Firstly, GBI design as energy efficient. GBI improve energy consumption by optimizing building orientation, minimizing solar heat gain through the building envelope, and harvesting natural lighting. GBI also give indoor environment quality. This will involve the use of low volatile organic compound materials, application of quality air filtration, proper control of air, temperature, movement and humidity. GBI also sustainable site planning and management. Selecting appropriate site with planned access to public transportation, community services, open spaces and landscape. And then for the materials and resources, GBI promote a use of environment friendly material source from sustainable sources and recycling. It is also water efficient, rainwater harvesting, water recycling and water saving fitting. The last is innovation. Innovative design and initiative that meet the objective of the GBI. So I will pass this news to Atira Holi.
That is the news for today. Before we close our news, let's watch the performance from a famous nasyid singer, Muhammad Iman Rida Osman, which has made Malaysian proud of his victory in an international competition.
There are several types of certificate that GBI offer to everyone. The first one is NRNC, stand for non-residential construction. Then we got residential new construction. The third one is an REB, non-residential existing building. The fourth one, INC, industrial new construction. The last one, IEB, industrial existing building. GBI is a very